Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Pokemon Ultra Sun Blind Nuzlocke, and I figured out a twirl, finally! I must have been just doing it wrong this whole time. I blame my circle pad. I bet it's broken. Yeah, it's totally my circle pad and not me. Are you a person of courage? Sure. That's nice for you. A person of courage, a person like you, be able to listen to my worries, be able to help me. Sure, why not? Only just to make myself talk to you like this, I'm afraid. That's how easily my courage is all used up. Just striking it with simple conversation. Dude, dude, I feel you. Please, can you tell me some sort of story of courage and starting to feel a bit braver? You've got nothing particularly new you can tell about. A tale of courage. Very interesting. So if I get past, like, a major story plot point, I can come back and tell him about my story. And it'll, like, make him, like, sound, let's say, like, ooh, wow, that's really cool. You inspired me to be courageous. And, like, he'll give me something? Because that's interesting. Alright, what does the sign say? Trainer tips. You want to sell... Yeah, I know that. Thanks. When you get your hands on a fishing rod, you physically can't get to this point until you get the fishing rod already. So, but thanks for that, though. Oh, hey, Gladion. Why do I do this? Every time something brings me down, I end up coming right back here again. Come on, Noel. We'll beat everyone who stands before us. We're going to be strong enough to protect them this time. Okay, that's different. That his dialogue different before he says, let's go bury our sorrow in the crowd. Yeah. Okay, Gladion, I like that line of dialogue better than your previous one. That's technically a step up. I'm giving you as much room as you can to improve. Believe me, I want to like you, but I don't yet. So, all right, we're going to go in there. I have Claymore up front, by the way. I don't know who else you guys would expect me to be using. And, yeah, Battle Royale Dome. And... glad you could make it! Oh my god, guys, who is it? I'm here today, yeah, to spread the word. Oh yeah, I'm a Battle Royale. They call me the Best Royal, woo! The what? The Best Royal! I'm here to teach you, oh yeah, about the battle for MPS and alone for generations. Pokemon Battle Royale, woo! But Royale, what's the Battle Royale, you might ask? Four trainers, yeah, he's picked three Pokemon, yeah, for one big Pokemon battle, oh yeah. Pokemon can't battle and more, yeah, that overall ends. Third Pokemon is taking out the most Pokemon, yeah, has the most Pokemon left, where's the winner, woo. I know this is exactly the same, but I love his dialogue, so. First, just give it a shot, pick your Pokemon, let's do it. Dude, it's the Master Royal, I want to battle. You there, come join the fun. Fun. I don't have fun. Discovery! New experiences! Adventure! It's all yours! And Hal's like, he invited Gladion? Well, there goes our fun time. The dome is packed and filled with excitement! Yeah, with the cardboard static images of audience. Yeah, real interesting. Alright, here are the contenders. Green Corner! Augmented is Claymore! How with Torracat! With Rockruff, this is exactly the same battle. Without Type Null! Maybe I should use Cutlass instead. Because Cutlass could easily kill Rockruff or Torracat really fast. Well, I guess they have Giga Drain. I'm gonna use Giga Drain on Rockruff. And here comes the lag! Giga Drain, Rockruff. Rockruff used to protect. Of course it did! Oh, that's great. Giga Drain, blocked. Fire Fang, I'm probably me. Oh no, Type Null! Yeah, go for Type Null. Tackle on me. Okay. Of course. Alright, let's try that again. What are the odds that they will... that he'll use Double Protect? That would be stupid. Thank you. Yeah! Boom! We win! That's the end! Knockout. Use Lick, Tackle. I think that the turn has to go by all the way. But ding, ding, ding. Yeah, we don't have an actual Battle Royale battle. Like, they... Like, Kukui, I mean, whoever the heck the Mass Royal is, explains the rules, but you don't follow those rules in this demo. You just have one Pokemon each. You were on fire during that battle. I couldn't believe you didn't even notice you were on fire. I had to put you out with water and didn't even notice that. My god, guys. Have you ever heard of stop, drop, and roll? I'm Kiawe, the fire captain. Oh, I have a trial over there. Climb to the top of the strongest stream. Okay, bye. Thanks, bye. Well, that was random. Hey, how are trials going? Master Royal, how do you know we're doing our trials? Oh, yeah, because we have amulets. I'm having a blast. Why are you here? Are you just mad to make some friends? Ha! You with friends? Ha! I'm not here to play. I'm here because you can't protect anything when you're weak. Well, he's right about that. Wow, you're a ray of sunshine, eh? That ain't a lot more fun if you just let yourself have a good time with everyone else. You're a lot more together, too. I don't know what his deal is. Alright, well. Gladion's lines have improved a little. I mean, he's only said, what, two things? Other than his initial conversation with us, which was exactly the same. So by default, I guess he's a little better. Oh, and I don't need you to hold the Sue Bell anymore. I'm gonna get rid of that. I'm gonna instead give you a poison barb. I'm pretty sure I have poison barb. Yep, poison barb. Perfect.
Awesome.
That is a very good item, but I don't want you up front anymore, because you don't need to be up front anymore, because you're a higher level than everyone else. Let's have Shamshir up front. Alright, is there anything down here that's cool? What is this? That's a Malasada shop. And what is this? Is this another photo booth? No, it looks like a fan club. Our club's for telling you so much love to offer around. It's actually kind of disturbing. Hello. Oh, we had fan club. There are people all around the world. Photos of the most beloved Pokemon. Meh. So cute and lovely and smart. Okay. More photos you take, the more affectionate it becomes. It could be more affectionate than it is to you now. Oh. Hey, do you know about the Everstone? I do! That's right! Hold on, for some reason, Pokemon doesn't evolve. I've stumbled upon another Everstone! Yes, it is all telling you about the whole nature thing. That's really neat that they actually tell you about that in the game. I don't know if they've done that before. Maybe they have, and I just haven't talked to the person who said that before. Carol's an amazing cook. Mellow special, it's like an explosion in my mouth, and then my head literally blows up and I die. Then I'm resurrected in the same spot. And whatever, it's worth it. Hey, a Murkrow. A Murkrow I can pet and play with? Great. Yeah, that's what Guts does. Okay, thanks. Oh, here is this that Marth? They like give you coupons for like good deals and stuff? It is! 50 Megamart where the sales are explosive! The funny part is I'm actually recording this on Thanksgiving, meaning the next day is Black Friday, so that's actually quite hilarious. This guy. There's something written on his chest. I'm just a poor hypno, share some love. I'm feeling generous today. Wow's really giving me this? Look like hypno, but it's actually just a person wearing a Pokemon costume. Look at you, big spender. I figured someone might give me money if only I was a Pokemon, but I had no luck. Until now, that is. You're a shining example of humanity. No, I just knew what this guy was. No offense. Good move for Hypno, right? Not particularly, actually. I don't know. I have rest and sleep talk now, about 2 TM, so I can use our rest sleep talk strategy at some point, I guess. Oh, sticker. Hey, sticker. I must get the sticker. I wonder what happened. Do you get a new totem Pokemon after each of the, like multiple of 20? That would make sense. Like 40, you get the next totem, like Araquanid, and then 40, you get whatever the fire one is. 60, you get whatever the grass one is. 80, you get something else, and then 100, you get something really special. And what the heck is that walking around? It's a Magmar. It's just a random Magmar walking around. Nothing suspicious here. Also, here's some water. Are you a trainer? Rare Pokemon that's been in the bubble sometimes. If I'm not mistaken, this route has more than just what's in the water. I feel like there is grass. I'd rather catch something in the grass. If I'm wrong, then whatever. I don't care. I'm just gonna rappel across the water so I can get across the water. So I can, just explore it a little bit before I catch something. No, that's the back end of the island. Yeah. There is a decent TM on this island, if I'm not mistaken. What's this over here? Oh! This! I believe these are Diglets. Should I catch a Diglett? I believe that's... I don't think there is grass. Maybe it's just that... Oh, is this where the TM for Leech Life is? No, I don't want to use another one right now. It's a Max Repel. Really? I could have sworn the TM for Leech Life is over here. I must be thinking of somewhere else that looks similar to this. There's nothing over here. Where's the other island? I know there's another island I can get to. Do I have to surf over there? I'm gonna hold off on getting a Diglett. I'll come back there if I don't find any grass. Because I'm pretty sure those are guaranteed to be Diglett with a very low chance of being a Sandygast. And, like, I'll actually get a freaking Sandygast. That'd be freaking amazing if I did, because I'd love to use something like that. But, maybe I have to surf from the other end of that island? Maybe that's what I have to do. That's the only thing I can see that I could possibly have to do. La 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 la, running past the holes. Oh, there's a swimmer person. I'm kind of wasting these repels, aren't I? But you know what? I don't really care. This is what they're for. And you know what? I could just use the map on the freaking bottom of the screen. But I honestly always forget that's there because I ignore Rotom constantly. So yeah, if I had just looked at the map, I could have figured, oh yeah, there's the top of the island right over there. But I didn't think to do that because, I don't feel like fighting those trainers. They're not really in my way. I could also fish in that random spot. I'll just fight you, I guess, though. Welcome, my mini island! I remember you. I don't remember what you had, but I remember you in the last game as you being here and stuff. Summer Vanessa! With a shelter. That should be fine, based on what we're using. Da-da-da-da! Beep, beep! I'll never get tired of that. Protect! Oh, yay! Good! Great strategy there! Wonderful strategy. Protect on the first turn. Yeah, protect. Keep using your protection. It doesn't always work. Bye. Hi, lost because I won't budge! Is that why you're using protect all? Was that the gimmick? You only use protect because you don't move? Okay, there has to be something on this island. Yeah, here it is. Double team? That's it? Anyone, another thing I feel like I missed? Isn't the TM for Scald on Brooklyn Hill? I'm gonna go back and explore Brooklyn Hill after this, maybe after I get Fly. But then again, Scald might be really helpful for the Fire Totem coming up. Maybe I should do it sooner than later. Oh, hey, an item at the bottom of the sea. It is an antidote, okay. Hopefully it's still good. Just been sitting at the bottom of the water for a while. I don't know. All right, so there is no grass, so I will get a Diglett. Because fishing, I would imagine, is most likely going to be Magikarp, and I don't want Magikarp to be here if I know there's a chance of getting something else. Because I guarantee you, I can get Magikarp pretty much everywhere that you can fish. So I'd rather save that for somewhere where. That's probably what I'm gonna get in Peniola Town, to be quite honest. Alright, well, what are you gonna be? Are you gonna be a Diglett or the low chance of Sandygast? Or something else? Who knows? Diglett. That's fine, I will catch Diglett. I did use Diglett for a decently long period of time in the Sun Nuzlocke, but that is alright. That is alright. I don't mind using it again. Because it's a new Pokemon. New-ish Pokemon. And I'm not sure what else here I can get. And that is not good. Never mind, you didn't appear. Thank you for not appearing. Why didn't you give me some quick balls? That would definitely be a good idea, if I do say so myself. Chomp! Don't kill it, don't kill it! Okay, I guess we don't get Diglett. Never mind, we get nothing on this route. Nothing! You lose. Good day, sir. Wonderful. All right, well, I guess Diglett does have crappy defenses, but I thought you would have survived the non-stab move, but I guess not. I guess I was wrong. Oh, no, I'm so sad now that I didn't get Diglett. All right, well, let's go back. Let's go back. Alright, now let's go to Well of Volcano Park. By the way, it does not eliminate Diglett from being captured. If I find another Diglett as my first encounter, I can still catch it. Because I didn't catch it. I just failed what I was trying to catch. You want to call Turos? Yes, I do. There's not enough room. Boom. Why would they put a rock there? Because there's a sticker here. Haha, I found it. I bet you didn't think I would find that one, game. Alright, so what's in Well of Volcano Park? I believe I caught a Magby here last time. Fletchling. Very interesting. Mako from my Y Sleeplock comes to mind, so I technically could say no to this if I want. But Mako didn't survive. Mako only got to Fletchling and then died. So I'm gonna get Fletchling. I'm gonna go with Fletchling, my friends. Let's use this, and I will throw balls. I mean, it's an early game bird Pokemon. It shouldn't be too hard to catch, in theory. Great ball. Great balls of fire! Probably doesn't have Galwings, and that's okay, because Galwings honestly isn't as good in this generation. They nerfed it, which I find stupid. Because Talonflame isn't that hard to counter if you know what you're doing with, yeah, if it has Galwings, you know. So, but whatever. That'll be a good backup for a flying type. I already know what I'm gonna name this thing, guys. I just realized I already know what I'm gonna name this thing. It just came to me as I was looking at it and thought, it's a flying type, right? This is Falchion. It sounds like Falcon. And the Falchion is also a legendary sword from Fire Emblem, which is the sword of both Marth, Crom, and Lucina, I guess. And I guess Alm at the very end. Yeah, Falchion. But the Falchion Fire Emblem actually does not look like the standard sword that is called a Falchion. Falchion is actually a curved sword. So that's the Falchion I'm naming after. The actual curved sword Falchion, not the one from Fire Emblem. You know what I think would be really funny, guys? If Honedge is in this game. Wouldn't that just be great? Honedge appears in my sword nicknaming theme game. I have no idea what I would name it. Like, I have no idea what I would name a Honedge. I guess something having to do with, like, darkness? I don't know. I honestly don't think Honedge is available in this game unless they added it. I don't know. I don't know what Pokemon they added to this game, except for the ones that I've seen so far. So, oh, that's not good. That's not good. That's not good. Four times. Okay. Is it just me or does Fomantis suck? Just if Fire-types hits four times or more again, I'm gonna die. So we're gonna switch out. Let's go to Flissa. Because each of those Fury Swipes will activate a stamina. So, oh, I should use Bite. That probably wouldn't have killed us, but it might have flinched us. So let's bulldoze it. Our Double Kick would have been work. Would work too, but well, we don't want to kill it too hard. Goodbye, Meowth. Thanks for coming to our island. Yay, a little for Epe. Leaf Blade! Heck yes! Getting rid of Leafage! Now we have both a really good physical and special grass move, which is exactly what I wanted. I think it's Cutlass's turn to be up front, because we're coming up to the fire trial already. I'm gonna rely on Cutlass and Flissa to take care of the fire trial, and I don't know if it's still Salazzle. I know nothing about this upcoming fire trial. I don't know if it's still Salazzle or if they changed it. So I guess we'll find out. We're not gonna go there quite just yet. We're gonna explore the we're gonna go around the mountain and then go back up first. Go down here. Anything around here? Nope. There's an item right here. And is there actual interior of the cave? Oh, floatstone. That's the most random item they could have thought of, in my opinion. I believe the floatstone, all it does is make your Pokemon lighter. Like, isn't that extremely specific and random? Like, all that would do is lower the effect of attacks that are... that base your, like, damage on weight. Which is really silly. Alright, we're gonna fight Ace Trainer Jim with his Noibat. That's interesting. We have Cutlass. Oh, that's a bad thing for you to have, I just realized. That is a very bad thing for you to have. Icy Wind! Super Sonic, you missed. You missed as well. Okay, now run. What is Icy Wind's accuracy? 95! That's unacceptable! Unacceptable! Cutlass, come on! Yay, Icy Wind! Super effective. Yay, bye-bye. I believe this is the other way one's Kadabra? Yeah, Kadabra. That's actually kind of bad. I don't think one attack will kill me, though. Let's use Water Pulse. Disable. Oh, good. I wasn't going to use Icy Wind. Thank you. Thank you. I was not going to use Icy Wind. Water Pulse. And one more. We're good. Just one more. Psybeam. We're fine, but we're confused. We're not fine, suddenly. We're not fine, suddenly! God dang it. Katana, you have really good special defense. Let's go to you. Psybeam, how much does this do to you? That's what I was hoping for. A Giga Drain. No! Come on! Really? You suck. Oh my god, this is stupid. This is really stupid. And I didn't heal Ippi, did I? Well, this is bad. This is gonna sound really stupid, but I'm gonna go to Claymore. Tell me Crobats suck one more time. Tell me not to use Crobats one more time, folks. I dare ya. I dare ya. No one else would have been able to get us out of that situation. To be fair, it is my fault I didn't heal half my team. So it would have been my fault if we died. No question there. But, and I almost got killed by a wild Magby. Almost. I tried to get away, couldn't get away, used Fire Spin, which made me have to attack it. I'm being really stubborn right now, I hope you know. I'm still not gonna heal. I'm not gonna heal. Okay, now I'll heal. I didn't realize there was more trainers in this route. Now I will heal. I will heal everyone to their max, not playing around anymore. I'm sorry, guys, no other Pokemon on my team right now would have gotten us out of that situation. Crobat took the hit from a super effective attack, no less, and went first. Katana or Cutlass would have been just fine if they didn't get confused. That's the only reason we were in that situation in the first place. It wouldn't have been a problem at all if they didn't get confused and hit themselves. Which, might I add, is a 1 in 3rd chance of happening in this generation, as opposed to 1 in 2. Because they nerfed confusion. Which I hate, by the way. I don't like if they nerf confusion, because you hit yourself just as often. I don't care what the odds say. You still hit yourself just as often. It's the opponents that don't hit themselves as often anymore. So that's why I don't like if they nerf confusion. Because the odds are not in your favor anymore. Because the odds are never in your favor for when it's bad stuff. When it's down to luck, things are never in your favor. Especially if you're doing Nuzlocke. But when you're doing some luck thing to the opponent, yeah, then the odds do matter. And, you know what I'm saying, I believe. Alright, yay, low for Cutlass, good job. Can we squeeze in the fire trial in this episode? It's gonna be cutting it close, but I don't know what else to do in this episode. You know, I keep forgetting that Cutlass is slow as heck. Like, I should not have Cutlass up front. Flissa, you go up front. I know you're probably slow as well, but whatever. Is there anything else to do on this route? No, that was everything, I believe. I think there's at least one more item to grab on my way down, right? Yes, here we go. It is a burn heal. We're gonna need burn heal for this next trial, I believe. All right, well, let's go. I'm gonna go back to a Pokemon Center and heal, and I'll be right back to this spot. All right, we're back. I've decided that I'm gonna start the trial in this episode. I don't know if we're gonna finish it. What does Flissa currently have? An amulet coin? I don't want her to hold that. I want her to hold a citrus berry. Do we have a citrus berry? I hope we have a citrus berry. I believe we have one. Because I didn't use it during... Oh, give. Yes. Because I didn't use it during the Araquanid Totem battle, and I kind of regret that. But I am still going to start with Cutlass. Flissa will be the backup. Actually? No. I changed my mind. Flissa's first. Because I thought about it. And, if someone had to die, I'd actually prefer Flissa because I've used a Mudsdale technically before. That's my only reason, to be honest. We're going to start this trial. I don't know if we're going to finish it in this episode, though. I am Kiawe. My Miracle and I are students of the ancient dance that passed down to Alola for generations. Trial of Kiawe. But that is a bit different than the trials we face at this point. Of course, we'll attempt it. Yes, of course. Is it still the same? Is it like the dancing thing again? Observation will be a dance in another. Yep, it is. All right, well, this is good. I don't care if this is the same. This is a good one. Yeah, memorize that still image. It's not memorize the dance. Memorize that still image. And then say what's different about the next still image. Yep, it's 100% identical. Middle Marowak. Yep. Now I gotta fight Marowak. This is another reason I started with, Flissa, because I knew this Marowak when it would show up, assuming it was like the previous one. And that's a physical attacker, and Flissa has stamina, so it only made sense to me. And while we're faster than it, that's actually kind of impressive. Bone Club. Dude, that's not even stab anymore on you, because you're Fire Ghost. Ah, well, that's good. And this is why I gave her the Citrus Berry, because she's gonna get low on health first, unlike Cutlass, and Cutlass will benefit more from the Mystic Water, doing strong water attacks, of course. So, yeah, Marowak was so pleased with the right answer, it simply had to battle you. Second dance, alright. The hiker's in the first one this time! Alright, there's the hiker. What's different in the second? What's different this time? The hiker is just looking differently now. Where they're standing, where they're looking, how they're smiling. Yep, that's it. The hiker's... Okay, that's a little less funny, because it kills the whole surprise of, oh, there's a freaking hiker just standing there. I don't know, whatever. What has he got? A Magmar, same thing. All right, I have the feeling it's going to be Salazzle again. That's all right. It's just Fliss is not much of a special defense person, which is, you know, Salazzle has uses special attacks. But whatever. Clear Smog. It's not very effective, dude. Why not use a fire attack? That's really random. All right, well, Bulldoze, you're gonna lower your speed, or we're just gonna kill you in one hit. That works. That works just as well. Yay, level for Flissa. All right, Hiker David, you're a fool if you can dance. You're a fool if you just look on. All right, guys, we're cutting this episode really close. You know what? I think I'm gonna save the totem for the next episode. Sorry, guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Hope to see you on the next episode where we're gonna fight the totem. It might be Salazzle, it might be something else, but at the rate this is going, I don't see why it wouldn't be Salazzle, so. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time, and as always, rock on.